Hello YouTube, Shaman Garbat here. Hello Steemit. I'm continuing my series with the Flight Gear Flight Simulator and my developed aircrafts. Today again the Tupolev 95MR. And today the task will be to fly the aircraft from Irkutsk northwest to Belaya. To the Belaya airport. It's also a military airport. It's not far away. So we are again on the Lake Baikal, Irkutsk region, Oblast Irkutsk. And let's go. So all the engines are running, the systems are prepared, and wait for the engines coming up and then loosen the brakes and let's go. We have now evening. The aircraft is full loaded, it's full payload and everything. A lot of full. And we have to bring it to Belaya. So let's start it up. I'm setting my vertical speed to 1000 now, because the runway is not so long, and I hope that I get up in the air now. Yep, I'm in the air. And we are checking the airport. It's here, so we go 180 degrees. Let's just go 180 degrees. Funny enough, in what direction the compass will go now, in this direction, okay? So we have the landing lights out now. Irkutsk, the big airport here, and our small airport here. I like Flight Gear a lot. You see now the light from the sun is illuminating the aircraft really nice, yeah. So that's one of the really amusing things in Flight Gear, the lighting system, also the clouds. This is really looking realistic in any way, so that's really nice. Also all the lamps and all the stuff, that's really super cool in my opinion. We have 4000 feet now, so I'm not changing anything at the moment. The airport is UEEB, so this airport I can put in the autopilot in the route manager, and I will land on the 30 right, and this shows me now the GPS to it, so I activate it. GPS settings and go to GPS now. So now the aircraft will fly with the help of GPS. And I have some values here. So my next waypoint is 30R. And I have a look to it. There's nothing in the map. Something is not correct. I've put the wrong airport. UEEB. Belaya. Okay. Let's go to Belaya. Activate this. And now we see the GPS coming up with the information. So that's the runway, and that's the next waypoint. It's 20 miles away, so we have to think about to go down. So I'm checking the altitude and putting the altitude 4000. The speed 280 at the moment. I will double the simulator speed for a moment. Maybe 4 times the speed. So that the video is not too long. I do not want to bore anyone. So let's go back to the normal speed. From outside Siberia. And anywhere there is the airport. So when we fly with the help of a GPS, then we have all the important informations in the hood. That's the green stuff here, that's the hood. And it shows me now that I have 51 seconds to go to the next waypoint. 4 miles now. And now it's turning into the direction from the next waypoint, and let's change to the next waypoint 33. Alright, so let's reduce the speed now to 170, and you also see that the altitude has now changed. It's now changed to 3500. So that's all the information that in the GPS is set, and we will fly on to the next waypoint in this altitude 3500, and then we go for 6.3 miles down to the airport. So easy enough. Just we wait to this waypoint GS, and then we go down. We see the airport here. So let's activate the gear, the flap, and then the landing light on. So we are prepared now for the landing. Speed is 170, and to the next waypoint it's 2.8 miles, so I can put the autopilot out and only the vertical speed now is set to minus 1200. Can activate the GPS also, but that's not necessary. I will fly it manually. I just wait till the trim systems have adjusted to my descent rate of 1200, and now they are adjusted to 5 meters per second. That's okay, and I can deactivate the autopilot. So now all the trims are set and I can make the landing manual. So I just have to get in the right direction of the runway heading. Be careful with the speed, of course. And always watching the stall, the angle of attack instrument. It's this one, with the red. So when the white arrow comes to the red, then we will crash. And now we are very deep. I have not take too much attention, as always when I'm explaining something. And now we try to get to the runway heading. Speed is way too fast. So I'm setting one more flap. And we are now on the runway and touchdown, reverser on, all flaps out and braking the aircraft down. So let's open the one, so I just click on the doors and they will open. It's also in the multiplayer, that's very nice. So let's hope that the aircraft will come to a stand before we go into grass. So a little bit of braking now. Okay, that's very nice, and we go to the replay. Just look for the last seconds of the flight. That's too fast, okay. Okay, let's just look to that. So without the noise of the engines, we can now look from outside how we did it. And the manual flight of this aircraft is really difficult. So it's not an aircraft for beginners. It's really difficult to fly. I'm shocked from yesterday, because I was crashed in the video. And in the comments the people tell me what wonderful flight it was, and so I know exactly that they have not watched the video to the end. But that's normal, nobody can watch all the videos which I'm making. 20 minutes, 30 minutes each video, and then every day one or two of them. That's maybe a little bit too much. So we see the landing, very nice. Not the smoothest one, but not bad at all. So change to the normal and go to my control back. So I have the control now. See, when I use the brakes, then there is the black stripes on the surface. I can close the doors also. Yeah. Click the two of them now and they will closing now. So we have a lot of different things in the scenery also with animation. So that's really a really nice flight simulator. And if you have too much time, then please check it out. Have fun. You can download all my aircrafts for free. Also the flight simulator is for free, so we are just passing some of my aircrafts, the Antonov 12, the red one, the Antonov 12, the yellow one. It's all made by me. Also the buildings here with the animation, and then we have a fleet of Antonov 12 for the military. So with this wonderful view from the Belaya airport, I will close down this video and see you next time. Bye bye.